Hey everyone, and welcome to another episode of the Map Completionist. I wasn't planning on doing this, but I'm actually going to go ahead and do the Black Citadel. As you can see, I already have some of it. I have some of it done just as I had to get some whatever I got while I had to make some important errands, running some important errands for myself. But I decided to at least kind of run through this because, honestly, if you ask me, this is one of the more confusing cities to reach all the different, particularly like all the points of interest. This doesn't have like a bunch of, I haven't made a bunch of notes or anything about this the way I do the other maps, about any of the interesting sites or things that can be seen here. It's just gonna kind of, I think this is really gonna focus more on getting some of the harder things to get in the cities, because there's nothing terribly difficult about a lot of the racial cities, except this one kind of has like a bunch of entrances and exits that goes to weird areas. So we're starting from where you would come in from Plains of Ashford. It's right through there's an entrance right in Village of Smokestead. When you enter, you're pretty much already getting the Ashford Gate, and you're automatically going to be given the Mustering Ground waypoint. There are three entrances total to the city. There's, of course, this one from Plains of Ashford. There's this exit that goes up into Diessa Plateau. You get the Diessa Gate waypoint if you came in here from Diessa instead of walking over there. Of course, I walked over there earlier. I needed to use the trading post. And there's finally, if you enter from Lion's Arch, because you aren't a char and you've never been to the city, this is likely where you're going to be coming from. The Lion's Arch surrogate is over here, and you get the Legacus Aquio? Aquio? I don't know. It's Latin. I don't know. Please forgive my terrible pronunciation. You get that waypoint. So I'm just gonna go ahead and start. If you're not a char, you've never played a char, and you want to know, the home instance is right here by the entrance from Plains of Ashford, and it's the Hero's Canton. It's right here at this gate, and this, I believe, it has four points of interest inside of it. So there you go. That's how you get into here. This is always one of the things that confused me, like trying to, I remember being confused as to where the home instance was, like when I was in Norn, or trying to go into the Norn city, but I had never played Norn before. So there is a point of interest here, the Ash Checkpoint 13, trying to see, I believe that, is that point of interest up there? Like I said, I'm kind of doing this, off the cuff. I don't have any notes, so I haven't even practiced this because I wasn't sure about what I was going to do. For all I know, I'll go back later and just completely narrate over this on my own. Okay, no, it's actually, I believe it's in here. Yes, it is. So the other two waypoints are inside this building. You go up, you get the 12th Iron Maniple. Maniple? I read that wrong. And then over here, we gotta go up the spiral staircase. But I could really use some constant swiftness. That would be nice. All right, the far of young heroes. All right, now I gotta get my butt out of here. Yeah, the last one isn't too difficult to get. Now, if you're relatively new to the game and you're seeing, like, I have all these, like, icons in my home instance of things that you might not have, like this skill point and this chest and this gift tree, those are all items you're able to get through different events to unlock in your home instance. Some of them, like this chest, I believe, comes from one of the collections. The Winter's Day gift tree came from Winter's Day, which is basically your Christmas holiday event. But let's, okay, so back here is the 20th Blood Court. I happen to get this while doing personal story time, so we'll go ahead and grab this. I let the char hide the Winter's Day tree behind all of this crap. Like, please don't show anybody we have a Winter's Day tree in here. That's pretty funny. I think that was, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, there's actually a fifth one, I think, here, because there's also the Belcher's Bluff. Some of these items I've gotten, you can also get from the Laurel Vendor, because they were rewards for the Living World Season 1, which you can't do anymore. But you can get them through the Laurel Vendor. Maybe I'll show that. Okay, so you get the Heroes Forum, and I do believe that is everything that you can get in Heroes Canton. So I'm going to go ahead and exit. Trying to do this like as quickly as possible. It's gonna be fast. All right, so Heroes Canton done. Let's see, what are we gonna do? Let's head to the let's head this way. Let's just head forward. Let me guess, it's up there. I was stupid and I came down here, and there's actually nothing down here, is there? Yep, there's nothing down here. Huh. That was a waste of time. Okay, so there's absolutely nothing down in Warwagon Prep. Good to know. This is why Amella takes tons of notes and has a spreadsheet open at all times, usually, for things like this. Alright. That's fine. We'll just head up here. This is also the Hero's Waypoint right here on the right. We can grab that, but I already have it, so you grab it. Okay, so it's actually in here. With all these guys hanging out with the cannonballs and stuff. This is the Vigil Chapter House. The Vigil's one of the three orders that you can play as, or you can join as you play your personal story. That's our headquarters here in the Black Citadel. So there's another waypoint over here. I think there's somebody else mapping around here. This is Junker's Waypoint. Lots of junk. If I start running into frame rate issues, know that it's actually something weird with my computer. Does not like the Black Citadel, and half the time when I get close to that giant sphere in the middle of the room, my frame rate goes down. I have to alt tab out of the game and come back. It's only the Black Citadel that does this. It's okay. So I ran through here. There's a whole bunch of different paths through this area that you kind of gotta be careful about. So enter through here. This is I got the Gladium waypoint. This is where all the Gladium hang out, the war bandless char. There's also a plebeian human. Hi, human. Why are you hanging? I don't know why you're hanging out in here, but that's cool. There's also a vista in here, so I'm gonna grab it. I don't know that I'm gonna necessarily put skips all around for the vistas. At least not in the city, because it's a little. Oh, hey. I got a daily without even realizing it. That's cool. And I believe that's everything for the Gladium Cantum, so I'm gonna head back up to Junker's Waypoint. Thankfully, we're in a city, so waypointing around is free. Not that it matters too much at this level. It's very little money to waypoint around everywhere. There is another point of interest over here. This is the Stormcaller Triumph. So the Black Citadel is actually built on the ruins of the old human capital when the human kingdom of Ascalon was still existed, their capital of Rin. And this thing here, there the Stormcaller is a giant horn. It's actually in a mission in Guild Wars 1. You find the mouthpiece for it when the humans are all like, oh man, this will help keep back the char. Prince Rurik blows the horn and then it rains. And it was like, oh. Yeah, rain scares the cats away. It didn't really do much, but they have the ruins of the horn there, which is kind of interesting. Let's see. There's so many different. This is what's confusing about the like Citadels. There's like so many little places that are kind of tucked into, kind of tucked in everywhere. And I believe, well, there's this, of course, but that waypoint that's or the point of interest there in the center is actually down here. At least I think it is. Is this the one I'm thinking of? There's several instances in the Black Citadel. Yes, it is Citadel Stockade. There's several different instances actually in the Black Citadel, which is what makes it so confusing trying to get some of these waypoints, or keep saying waypoints, points of interest. All right, so Citadel Stockade, that was down there. Let's see, doo 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 doo. Blood Tribune. Okay, yeah, I knew I missed something. I missed the. It's on the outside there, and I messed up how to get there. All right, well, we're gonna head up. Wait, no. No, I didn't. That's. Okay, so this would be the Citadel. Wait, no, that's still Citadel Stockade. What am I thinking? See, this is the problem. Okay, so Black Citadel is weird. It's one of the few cities where none of the. It's not in layers at all on the map. There's no different layers to click on to kind of see what's where. And so it gets a little confusing after a while looking at these points of interest on your map, because you can't tell what's above or below you. Because as soon as you get it, it stops telling you. So it's just really, really bizarre. Okay, so there are some other instances now. I think there's one over here, I believe. This is the Ash Tribune headquarters, the entrance here. And we gotta. Oops, I'm leaving it. It's so weird. Okay, it opens the door in front of you, so it's actually. I got turned around, sorry. So we go up the ramp here, and it's this point of interest here. Come on. You know you're there if you see Torga Desert Grave. Desert? Yeah, desert. Torga Desert Grave. We'll leave this instance. Okay. Now, of course, there are a couple more instants for the other legions, so we gotta get them all. Here's the command core. It's the one in the middle. Oh, right. You actually have to come up and climb up here, up this ramp, and then all the way in the back here, you get the war council. And if you come over here to the left, where Bure Goreblade is, you will get the Iron Tribune quarters. So this is because the Black Citadel is in Iron Legion territory. So the Iron Legion kind of runs things here. So the other two legions, the Ash and the Blood Legion, have headquarters in their own instances, but they're not as big because this isn't technically their area. So we got most of those. Now there should be over here, which is the Blood Tribune quarters, which is what I was confused about. I did get this when I was doing the personal story already, so this is why I didn't know. If you see Britlock Bloomstone, you're in the right place. Blood Tribune quarters. All right, let's go. No, sometimes, I guess depending on your story and who you are, he might not be there. I think it depends. And I want to say that looks like everything for Imperator's Core. Let's see. Oh, I forgot there's speed bonuses. One of them's right here. one of the few instances where you actually can use Charm Dignity or Ferocity, but it really doesn't do anything. Either way, he gives you the speed boost, doesn't matter what you pick. so don't worry about it. Now, on this layer below the top is actually where all the cultural armor people are hanging out. So here's your tier 3, your tier 2, tier 1 is over there. So it's second to highest when you're inside the giant sphere, core, whatever you want to call it. Let's see. Doop-a-doo. I'm just gonna jump down here. And I don't remember where the cultural weapons are here. My bad. Like I said, I'm not pointing out too much of that stuff in this case, just because it's in this is a city that's mostly just confusing in where you find things, and most of the cities contain all the same things as, you know, your cultural armor, your cultural weapons, and once you know how that works, it's not too bad. Alright, so this is the Memorial Waypoint. I actually, I think I skipped, I was paying attention, and oh no, that's Heroes Forum. See, this is what I'm talking about. Heroes Forum is technically in Heroes Canton, and it looks like I skipped something, but I didn't. It was just right there. Ugh, this city can be very confusing. Okay, so if you want to get that vista over there, we actually have to keep going around this way. And it's just down here. See the statues? Go straight ahead. Climb on the glass. Oh, my frame rate's starting to get a little finicky. Thank you, Black Citadel. Alright, so another vista down. As you can see, we're now where all the crafting and everything is. So, very handy place. In the middle of it all, there is a tavern called the Serrated Blade, which is this point of interest, which I already had. And the waypoint over here, which is the Factorium waypoint. So, that's also right here. Now there's you can see a lot of the ruins of the old wall, a lot of Ascalonian architecture ruins, and you'll actually see a bunch of priory hanging out here. Another one of the orders, and this is Derman Scriptorium. This is where they hang out in the Black Citadel. So that covers that area. I'm gonna head back over to the Memorial Waypoint. I'm just like blasting through this as fast as possible. Alright, so at the end of this area is this is the Diasa Gateway point. I already have it, but right out there that would lead to Dias Plateau. Don't know if it's Diasa or Diasa, and I haven't listened to anyone actually say the name of the place, so I could be pronouncing that all wrong. Sorry if I am. Alright, the Plaza of Remembrance. Nice little monument here. Did they actually tell you what it is? What can I do for you? Wall of Fallen Warbands. Names of those who have died in service of the legions are immortalized here. Yep. Okay. There's all sorts of interesting things. There's a bunch of different Char heroes you can read about. Kala Scorchrazor, who led the rebellion against the Flame Legion. So then female Char were once again allowed to be in the military with the rest of the ranks and weren't just relegated to, you know, cooking and whatnot. So over here, if we walk across, this is where the Surrogate to Lion's Arch is. And like I said, if you come out from here, you will get this waypoint automatically. It doesn't even pop up or give you any XP, because it's one of those waypoints that you would get by default just by entering the location. Retreat. So next off, there's a little door here, as you can. The elevator to I didn't even read what it said. Elevator to perimeter loop. Okay. It said something else coming down because it's. I think I already got the point of. The point of interest that might have been here? Because I believe there was one. I think. Or maybe not. Because I was actually already here for a personal story. But there is a waypoint over here. The Bane waypoint. Maybe that is the only thing down here. Maybe there isn't a point of interest. This is what's so confusing, is not being able to peel back these layers and actually see what was on one of the... Because, like, Blood Tribune quarters, this is like four floors above us. Ash Tribune quarters, four floors above us. It's very, very confusing. Alright, I believe this... So I guess this waypoint was all that was actually down here. Let's see. Vidium Canton. And... Oh, I didn't actually go down through any of this. There's more stuff over by Gladium Canton that I didn't do, which is actually how you get down to all this here, all the old Ascalonian ruins. I'm just trying to make sure I got everything else that I can get up here. I think so. So I'm actually gonna head back over to the Junkers waypoint. And if I made a mistake. That's okay. Oh yeah, here's what I missed. I didn't go past it and go. No, I did. I just didn't. Oh, I didn't go to. I only went right. I didn't go left. That's what I missed. My bad. And let's see. What do we, here's the vista. Off to our left. Look at all that junk being melted down. It's kind of scary, really. It's just open. I mean, yeah, there's a thing, but geez, just fall from here and you're dead. Burnt in the molten molten metal. That's terrible. Retreat. I think I've ran out of my speed boost, haven't I? Now, this was elevator to Gladium Canton. I'm thinking of... Maybe I'm thinking of that elevator? Because I don't think it's in the Gladium Canton itself, is it? Or did I just miss it? I may have just missed it. This map is very confusing. Not too bad once... You know it, but it's like when you're... Oh yeah, I did. I just completely missed the elevator in here. Of course I did. So here, we're gonna go down to the ruins of Rin. And, ooh, here we are. Ruins of Rin. Fantastic. Most of these karma vendors only have silly stuff like that. So, here we go. There's the,
retreat.
The ruins of Win. Ruins of Win. Blah blah blah. English. I'm terrible tongue twisters, apparently. Ruins of Rin waypoint. And there's an annoying vista to get up here. I guess I will put a skip for this one if you want to figure out how to climb for yourself. And just jump. Man, I'm getting better at this jumping as a char thing. Awesome. Okay. And up this, and here, and... I'm just like trying to blast through the city as quickly as possible so I can get back to the other things. I might revisit the cities later and do like a, like cool things to see in the city or interesting... You know, interesting things that can happen, but now it's not that oops! Dodge roll right off there, because we are brilliant! Let's see. There isn't a, point of interest down there. There is one over here to the left. So, more ruins from the old human city that they're just kind of demolishing and trying to... The Priory's trying to study them before they're all destroyed and absorbed into city proper. Alright, abandoned cavern, access prohibited. That's not scary at all. Okay, let's see, we're already almost done. We're just missing the haunted Nolani waypoint and this last vista. So yeah, super easy. Once you know where you're going, but sometimes when you're going through for the first time, if you've never played a char and you've never had to do it, it can be particularly, you know, finding all those instances and the fact that the map isn't layered can make it a little difficult if you haven't done it before. Well, I go get this waypoint, which is super easy to get. This is, if they continue to do the same Halloween event that they've did the last 2 years, or at least make that content available, this is actually important to Halloween. And that's actually, I believe, when it was added. I don't think that, I'm pretty sure that waypoint hadn't been there at release. So to get up from this vista, you're gonna come from this, I guess, well, if it's to my right, then you're coming from the left. So you wanna come across these little rocks here. Oh, careful, don't fall. And then, I'm trying to remember what I can jump on. My biggest issue with jumping puzzles or other thing in Guild Wars, you can't always tell what you can climb on and what you can't. It's not always immediately clear. Alright, and Vista. And we are done with Black Citadel, so that gives us, for the cities, because they're so easy to do, and you can do them at pretty much any level, as soon as you start the game, really. You can just back up and go into them because you don't have to worry about levels or things killing you, aside from if you fall, of course, but that's your fault. You only get experience points and a transmutation charge. That's all you ever get from a city. But it's a nice way if you ever really, really run out of transmutation charges and you know a city well enough to just kind of do a speed run through it, you can just keep making new characters and get them that way if you really want to. Personally, I have so many I don't care. But thank you guys. I do feel bad that I'm not really spending any time to show any particularly cool things about this map. I may, like I said, I may revisit it and kind of show, like, if there's any dialogue or anything. Right. I keep getting messages, so I don't remember what I was saying last before I had to, it's probably going to be cut, like, mid-sentence or something really awkward like that. But as I was saying, we finished Black Citadel. By the way, the karma, the cultural weapons stuff, I was forgetting where it was, but it's right up here next to the Diasic waypoint. So easier to reach than the armor guys. Now, next time we will be heading into Dias Plateau, however that's pronounced. And maybe sometime I'll do a follow-up video that kind of covers some of the interesting lore bits or whatever or anything interesting that might happen in the city. This is just kind of, I didn't want to spend a lot of time in the city, to be honest, so I was just busting it out as fast as I could, ran through, and I definitely wanted to do it for the Black Citadel, at least because there are so many instances and it can get very confusing with the no layer thing and the fact that there's so many different instances. As you can see, even I got confused while I was trying to map, like, something that I got. I was like, wait, where was this again? Why do I have this already? Because it doesn't sort by layers for whatever reason in the city. So thank you all for watching, and I will see you all next time.